Hey Chris, I guess the first question is a simple one. Just how's it feel to be back out there with the guys after missing so much time?
You said how's it feel to be back?
Yeah.
It's an amazing feeling, man. Like I've been saying, it's been a blessing. It's been a long time, like 19 months. So just to be able to be back around the team and with my guys on the field, it's really been an honor.
Go ahead, Alec.
Yeah, Chris, just how tough, you know, was the rehab process the last year? Not only having to rehab, but having to kind of do it, obviously, with COVID being there and all the protocols in place.
It was pretty tough. And more so mentally. I feel like it helped me as a person, you know, overall, strengthened my faith. But it wasn't really just me, myself. It was a lot of my teammates. We lost a lot of guys, so pretty much all of us, we all just rehabbed together, and we had one goal, and it was to come back so we can all compete together and come out for the next season.
And then how are you feeling right now? Like, how's the knee been feeling throughout camp and all that?
Oh, yeah, I feel amazing, man. I'm just glad to be back with the team. We're all out here competing, and we're all, you know, holding each other to a standard, regardless, you know, if we're coming off of an injury or however we did last year, we're glad to be out there.
James Henderson, go ahead, please.
Yeah, Chris, how do you balance competing for a starting job, but also being a vocal leader? I know you've talked about it in the past, being one of the leaders at cornerback. How do you balance that while you're out there?
I mean, as a leader, you know, I hold everyone to the same standard. We all hold each other to the same standard, you know. We all want to compete regardless of who's the starter. It doesn't matter. Competing is in our DNA in that cornerback room. And, like, leading those guys, I feel honored because this group of corners is, I feel like it's been the best since I've been at NC State. So I'm glad to be with those guys.
And just to follow up, I know you've played cornerback, I think, your whole life. I know you came in, you were recruited to play cornerback. Being away for a while, is it like riding a bike, getting back out there in that sense? I mean, is there or was there some rust for you?
Pretty much, yeah. Like you said, pretty much my whole, like, college career I've been at corner. So I feel like it's kind of like riding a bike. It's going to come back to you. Those instincts are going to come back to you. It's just, you know, the scheme, you know, getting your feet back under you and just, again, the chemistry of the defense, that's going to be really big. So I feel like the more we get rest, it's just going to be like you said, riding a bike. It's just going to click.
Thank you.
David Thompson.
So, yeah, Chris, so, you know, a week into practice, where do you feel like you are in that metaphor of riding a bike? I mean, are you able to change gears yet or, you know, how – just where are you at in that progression?
Oh, yeah, for sure. I'm changing gears. I'll pop a wheelie. Like, I feel like it's just – it's fun, man. Like, I'm out here. I feel like a kid again, man. I wasn't able to play football. So, you know, once you're out there, it's just – it's full go.
Is there something you lose with a year of – obviously, you've stayed in shape and with conditioning, but the football conditioning is – is that maybe something that you still need to get or are you flying?
No, because I feel like I worked on my mental so much. Once you're mentally tough, I feel like that football shape is going to come straight to you. Like once you get out there, you push yourself. All you got to do is push yourself. And like I said, it's all about the mental.
So I'm sorry, one last question. I've heard every player has really talked a lot about the mental part of the game. Is that something you guys have really done as a team or is that something just individually you've sought?
I feel like this offseason has been pushed as a team because a lot of our mistakes last year, you know, were mental mistakes, you know, pre-snap penalties. So stuff like that, once we get that down and we become mentally tough, you know, no matter their environment, we execute, then it's going to be real good.
Jalen, go ahead.
And missing that year last year, how were you able still to impact the team as a leader last year?
my favorite part of football is the classroom and knowing, you know what I'm saying, knowing the scheme. So just being involved in that meeting room when we meet as a unit and as position, just being involved, you know, giving my input, you know, watching the film, we like, okay, you could have did this better, or next time read this and then go here. You know what I'm saying? Like just and basically reiterating what the coaches are saying, like on the field, I feel like that was just part of what I do already on the field, like even when I'm playing. So I feel like I was still, you know, a part of the team.
And also, what all do you remember of the exact moment when you got hurt? And did you ever feel like in that moment that you would be gone for so long?
What I do remember of the play, I just remember the game was going pretty well. It was right before halftime. You know, I put myself in a position where I feel like I could have, you know, could have put myself in a better position where I wouldn't have gotten hurt. But, you know, we can't get that back. So it's just something I learned from. And, yeah, that's pretty much it was a learning moment.
Go ahead, Jonas.
Coach Doran said last week that the tight end battle in camp is one that he'll keep his eye on. He's even interested to see how it shapes out. You guys have so many guys who have started a bunch of games. What's the competition like at that position, and how much does it push you guys, and how do you get separation when there are so many guys with so much experience?
I feel like, to hit on that last question, the separation, I feel like you want that separation, but at the same time, I don't want too much separation from the first guy or the last guy. That's because I feel like if it's a drop, you know, somebody go down, God forbid, or something happens, somebody tired, oh, we can put the next guy in. You know what I'm saying? I like that depth in the corner room. That's what I'm saying. That's why I'm so excited to work with those guys, because it's so much competition. And I feel like it's, like I said earlier, it's the best group I've been able to be around since I've been at NC State.
Anybody else have anything for Chris? Chris, thank you.